one, two, three, and. Chico, don't be discouraged. The man, he ain't so hard to understand. If you try now, I know that you can lend a helping hand, because it's good in everyone, and a new day has begun. You can see the morning sun if you try, and I know things will be better.
Not a traffic jam.
Nice of you to show up, Brown. Pillar up,
he says. You gotta be kidding. I sell gasoline, not embalming fluid.
Half a cup of coffee.
You want a full cup?
Yes.
Now get out of here.
With pleasure. Eso me pasa a mí por venir aquí.
Hey, hold it, Mr. Wait, no, no. All right.
And the next time you come in, stay out.
And you almost let that guy drive off with the only gas pump.
Your people are always trying to steal something.
You're just saying that because I stole your heart away.
Stack your cans up side by side. Hold your hands and take it for a ride.
How you feeling, Louie? Hey, did you check into the banquet hall for Ed's party?
Yeah, Chico, I rented the Carmen Miranda room down on Alvera Street, and it can hold 50 guests.
Well, that's 48 more than we'll have.
Good morning, gentlemen.
How you doing on your invitations?
Well, so far I got two maybes, one you gotta be kidding, and six not on your lives.
You know, maybe we better not tell everybody it's a party for Ed. Let's tell them it's a lynching.
Yeah, and I'll cancel out the Carmen Miranda room and get a rope instead.
Make sure it's a long sea rope.
Hey, what is this, a garage or a union meeting hall?
Well, we're talking about your party, birthday boy.
I'm not your birthday boy, and I'm not going to that party.
Well, we'll have a better time that way, and the whole gang will celebrate without you.
What gang? Who's coming?
Well, it's going to be a small but select group.
Let me see that. Only two names on here, and they're both maybes?
Well, we're trying to keep it intimate. Well,
you can cross O'Brien off, because I owe him $40. You can take out Patterson, because he owes me $30.
And you're going to keep on scratching off names. Ain't going to be nobody's name on there left but Chico, Dell, and me.
Who invited you?
We're the co-hosts.
Oh, boy, some party. Three co-hosts and no guests. Well, I'm not going to that party, you hear? I'm not going to that party.
Oh, yes, you are going.
Please, pass a miracle so these unfortunates can hear again. And you're going to strike me deaf so I don't have to listen to him anymore.
I don't understand you, Ed Brown. Why can't you be happy? You have a gift not given to many. You've lived a long life.
Turtles live longer. Did you ever see a happy turtle?
Ed, turtles are born with shells. You grew one.
Yeah, that's right. And all new, it looks terrible.
So don't look.
I won't. And Della, you can just cross my name off that list because I ain't going to be there. Bye.
Get out of here.
Well, are you happy now?
Well, I admit things are looking up.
Well, I'm going to make your day complete. You can cross me off too, Chico.
Oh, good. Now we're down to one host and one guest of honor.
Chico, may I suggest that your main course be a bucket of oats because your guest of honor is a jackass.
You can cancel that cake. I'm on a diet. I'm not going to any birthday parties.
Why, Ed? Why? Why won't you celebrate?
Why? Because at my age, you don't celebrate birthdays, you mourn them. No disrespect, sir, but why can't you make people realize that growing old is nothing to celebrate?
Hello! Is anybody here? Don't you know that you never refer to a non-commissioned officer as sir?
I remember that.
I am Private, First Class, B.J. Foster, United States Army, retired. Also, I am a friend of Ed Brown's. Now, I assume that he is alive and kicking.
No, just kicking. I'll tell him you're here. Hey, Ed, a friend of yours is here to see you.
Gotta be an imposter. I don't have any friends.
Hey, it's me, Ed Foster.
Foster, what for? Blinky Fo... Blinky Foster! Hey, wait a minute. It can't be you. I read in their veterans bulletin that you died 2 years ago.
I read that too, but I didn't believe it.
Oh. Well, they said in your obituary you had a heart attack.
Yeah, I did, but the medics attacked right back, and now with my new pacemaker, the old ticker's ticking better than ever, huh?
Mr. Foster, come sit down. Yeah. Oh, being a friend of Ed Brown's is not only a pleasure, it's a rarity.
Yeah. Oh, Chico, get me my bottle and a couple of glasses.
Oh, no, not for me, thanks. Oh. No, I can't touch a drop since I lost one of my kidneys.
You lost a kidney?
Oh, now, don't look so shocked, Ed. The old transplant is doing just fine.
Something wrong with your leg?
Well, it's not mine yet. I'm taking it out for a little test hobble. One of those new aluminum jobs.
Blinky lost the original at Anzio.
Yeah.
Ah, tell me, Blinky, what are you doing in L.A.?
Well, we're here to visit my wife's folks. They haven't met my new leg yet.
Hey, didn't I hear that Agnes passed away about 7 or 8 years ago?
That's right, she did, poor dear. Then I married Muriel, and she passed away 2 years ago. But Selma is 37, so I figure she has a few years left before she pops.
Did you see that, Ed? Did you see that?
What? What happened? His arm fell off?
Here's a man with a pacemaker, a kidney transplant, an aluminum, a tin leg, and he still can smile. Doesn't that tell you something?
Yeah, it tells me he's definitely not going to be in the next Olympics.
That is where you're wrong, Ed. I'm entered in the 50-yard limp.
Please tell me how a man who has gone through so much can still be so happy.
Who says I'm happy? What I am is cheerful. There's a difference. And if you... Who are we talking to?
You're talking to God. Ed's always bugging him.
Who says I'm bugging him? He never complained to me.
Sure, that's because you bug him so much he won't even talk to you.
Well, I have got to hop along and take Selma to lunch. Why don't you join us, Ed?
Oh, I'd be delighted, but only on one condition.
Oops, I am picking up the check.
That's the condition. Well, I got to go upstairs, put on a formal sweater. I'll join you in about 5 minutes.
Blinky?
Listen, you're an old friend of Ed, so I feel I can speak freely. I'm kind of worried about him.
Why?
Well, you could say it's a cost of living. With Margaret gone, the price is too high.
Oh, that's too bad. He was always such a happy kid during the war.
Well, sure, then he had an enemy to hate. Now he's got to settle for hating his friends. Isn't there anything you can do to help?
I wish there was, but my name is Foster, not Freud.
You know, we were going to throw him a birthday party and everything, and he did everything he could to ruin it. Don't you think you could change his mind?
Oh, look, kid, if God can't get through to him, what chance is a mere angel like me, huh?
Hey, wait, hold the phone. You just said it.
What did I say? I wasn't listening.
Every time Ed talks to God, it's a monologue. Suppose one day God was to answer him back.
God? You have got to be joking.
No, I'm not, and I know you can do it with your voice.
Oh, no, not me. Even Rich Little doesn't imitate God. Sorry, kid.
I say verily unto thee that thou can doest.
Please, Blinky, give it a shot.
Oh, no, I could never pull it off. Well, the only thing I ever had any success at imitating was, old soldiers never die. They only fade away.
Douglas MacArthur, how much closer could you get?
You got it. Yes, Douglas, you know, maybe if I just try... Oh, no, we'd never get away with it. Ed would not believe that for a minute.
Yeah, but it might shake him up for a second. What can we lose? You take Ed to lunch. By the time you get back, I'll have it all set up.
Okay, I'm ready.
Good, Ed. So's Blinky.
Oh, good.
Vaya con Dios.
Chili con carne.
Struck me down with lightning, so I figure I got the okay.
Oh, boy, Blinky. I really gotta hand it to you. An old coot like you, married to a young, hot-blooded girl. Hey, how do you keep up with her?
Oh, that's easy. I just flick my pacemaker into overdrive. Hey.
Hey. What's wrong with you?
I'm tuning the horn.
Oh. Tuning the horn. Well, knock it off. I don't want to listen to the mating call of a 64 Chevy. Hey, will you stop that?
I can't help it. Something's wrong with it. It's stuck.
Oh, well, fix that. Next time he wants to honk, he'll have to squeeze a goose.
My goodness, look what time it is. I better hurry along. Phyllis always blows her top if I'm late.
Phyllis, I thought your wife's name was Selma.
It is.
You do such a stupid thing.
Stupid? It was an accident, man. Don't call me stupid.
All right, then. You're dumb.
Dumb, huh? That does it. I'm packing.
Wait a minute. Dumb is smarter than stupid.
You were right the first time. I'm stupid for hanging around here, man. I give you the best years of my life. I scrimp and save to make a nice garage for you. And what do I get for my trouble? Abuse. Well, I'm tired of it. Do you hear me? I'm tired of it.
What do you want? A raise or a divorce?
I don't want anything from you.
You got it.
Listen, don't try to make up with me. You're a rotten, mean, senile old man.
You left out Violet. Stay up.
Go ahead. Hit a one-handed defenseless man. Go on.
I'm not the Pharaoh of Egypt. Why have you visited me with this pestilence?
That's another thing. If you're going to keep bugging God, I'm leaving. Maybe he wants to hear it, but I don't. See?
Wait a minute. Come back here, Chico. Come back here. I want to talk to you. Hey, stop that. Come out of here. Hey, Chico, let me...
showtime. Remember, sir, this is Chico's idea, not mine.
I'll never understand that boy. Have I really been such a monster to him?
Verily thou hast.
Holy.
Don't say it.
Didn't thou hear something? I heard something.
I did hear indeed. I heard thy cries of pity, which have given me a stiff pain in the ear.
Oh, I need a stiff drink.
If thou persistest in thy wicked ways, I shall close my gates of heaven unto thee forever.
Oh, please, tell me what you want me to do, and I'll do it. I'll do it.
Chico Rodriguez is a sterling lad. He helpeth other people at all times. He keeps himself physically strong, mentally awake, and morally straight.
Ah, yes, yes. He is a good scout, verily.
Joke not with me.
No, why not? Thou hast a great sense of humor. Look what thou hast made us. The camel, the giraffe, and even Louis the garbage man.
Verily I say unto thee, thy friends Louis and Della are noble and true. They have, out of love, prepared a birthday celebration in thy honor. I commandest thee, goeth.
Sir, I'll see you in church. My son.
What's happened to you?
I cannot tell you now, but when I can, thou will be the first to know. My boy. Senor Lopez, a little gift for you.
Oh, no, no, Brown. On your birthday, gifts are for you.
Oh, no, you've already given me a gift, amigo. The gift of friendship. Bless you. Ah, oh, Mrs. Valescus, my favorite delicatessen lady. Here is something for you, my dear.
Oh, thank you, Ed. Yeah. Oh, I feel terrible.
What?
All I got you was a 2-pound salami.
But I shall cherish it forever.
Only if you keep it in the freezer.
Bless you, my dear. And Della. Della, happy my birthday.
Oh, Ed, your religious experience has made you into a new man.
Peace. May you live to be 120.
With my arthritis, forget it.
Into each life a little pain must go.
Ed, you touched me. All the pain is gone.
Not so loud. I'm not licensed to practice healing.
Oh, I can't hardly wait to see what this is in here.
What is it?
I don't know. I'm going to hold that. Do you believe this? A baby doll?
He gave me a moon ring.
Yeah, what kind of mood he in?
I don't know, Chico. Ed's attitude must be doing something to me, man, because it's a sickly green.
You know, this is quite a novelty, seeing Ed going from sinner to saint, but enough's enough. Chico, you've got to tell him what you've done.
Oh, I can't. My medical insurance doesn't cover stupidity.
Oh, Ed ain't gonna kill you, man.
Yeah, but he might turn me into a pillar of salt.
Ah, oh, my dearest friends, are you having a good time?
We're having a wonderful time, Ed. Just stand right up here. And Chico's got something he wants to tell you. Excuse me.
Yes, my son.
Ed, you know what I've always liked about you is your wonderful sense of humor.
Well, it is written. There is a time for weeping and a time for laughter.
I hope this is the time for laughing.
Ed, you know, you're that rare, wonderful human being that can laugh at a joke, even if it's on him.
Yes, that is true, my son. But you're perspiring, my boy. Is it warm in here?
Only for some of us.
Tell him, Chico.
Forgot the punchline.
Well, I remember. Hey.
Never mind, Louie.
For he's a jolly good fellow. For he's a jolly good fellow. For he's a jolly good fellow. Which nobody can deny.
Happy birthday. Happy birthday. Now, Ed,
yes, my dear.
Close your eyes and blow out the candle.
Close my eyes and blow out the candles. I shall do that. Ready?
Take a wish.
1, 2, 3.
I did it. Speech.
My dear friends, I want to thank you all for joining me on this happy occasion. But most of all, I want to thank someone who has turned my life around and made all this possible. Thank you, sir.
Thou art welcome.
All right, front and center. Hep, 2, 3, 4. Hep, 2, 3, 4.
He talks to him like that.
Ed, you knew, huh?
From the very beginning. I've heard Blinky do his General MacArthur 100 times. And it's still lousy.
I'm sorry, Chico. Here, Ed. Here's a good spot.
Oh, no, Chico, I'm not sorry to you. If you went to all this trouble to get me to come to my birthday party, I have to thank you. And as for Blinky, well, you may have put the idea in his head, but he put the idea in yours.
Then we're forgiven?
You're forgiven one and all. And now the first slice will be for Chico.
Oh, thank you, man.
You like it, Ed? I picked it out myself.
Sure. Ed, wait to see what I got you.
Yeah, I want to see that.
Hey, open this up.
Okay. Yeah. What is it?
That's for old mechanics. It's a grease gun with a telescopic sight.
Hey, I got something for you, Ed.
Yeah, well, Louie, bring yours out.
Okay.
Oh, look at the size of it.
Oh, it's so big.
Oh, this is beautiful. Like this,
Ed. Hey, that's beautiful. Let me see. What is that?
Yeah. Monogram, man. Look at that.
Louie, did you steal this from Ernest Borgnine?
Oh, just what I need.
What are you doing? Ed, stop it. Those are nice gifts. You should be grateful.
That's right, Ed. Not everybody has friends that would throw him such a swell party.
I hate parties. And I'm never going to have another one.
Oh, yes, sir.
Was recorded live before a studio audience at NBC Studios, Burbank, California.